karma yoga and jnana yoga are must for everyone. Therefore, there is no choice. And when Krishna advised Arjuna to do karma, not as an option, but as a preparatory step. Therefore, Krishna's advice is, Arjuna, do karma, purify, gain knowledge, and be free. This is essence of Gita. Act, purify, know, and be free. This Krishna has made very clear, no confusion. But Arjuna did not listen properly, and therefore he mistakes Krishna. This is called filtered listening. This is one of the greatest problems any student will face. When he comes to the class, he wants to listen certain things, because already he has formed a clear-cut philosophy. Like some people say, Kali Yugatthila Bhakti Yogandhaan. Shuali Arnala Mandala Pottu Vijjurupan. Jnana Yoga will not work in Kali Yuga. Karma Yoga will not work in Kali Yuga. Or they will say, for emotional people, Jnana Yoga will not work. Bhakti Yogandhaan work. Bhakti Yogandhaan Aļanam. Erikkenave Aļudhundhurukkoon. Adho konja vede continue pandhurukkoon. Because they have defined Bhakti Yoga as crying. And already you are crying, continue that in the name. Like that we have got certain fixed notions, and we listen with a filter in our brain. And whenever Swamiji tells something which already you have thought of, Swamiji innaki nanna pesinar. Enna nartamna avan nenachathe ela solvitar. When children and parents listen, when both of them are listening to the class, whenever I criticize the parents sometimes, the children note that very well. And appa enna solra paathunga Swamiji. And whenever I criticize the children, then the parents will note. So this is called filtered listening. Arjuna wanted to avoid karma, and therefore he did not listen properly. Krishna's advice was, karma is necessary, and then jnanam is necessary. And based on this wrong grasping, Arjuna puts the question. But the greatness of Krishna is, Krishna does not blame Arjuna. He does not say, you have not listened properly. Solapadadana if a shishyan guru perla blame pada guru ku padapadana nee da asadu achippichu solapadadana. The greatness of the teacher is he listens to the question as though it is a fresh and intelligent question, even though it is born out of improper listening. Krishna never blames. He teaches the whole thing once again, elaborating the importance of karma yoga. Thus you will find the third chapter will elaborate karma yoga portion. The fourth and fifth chapters will elaborate jnana yoga portion. With this background, we have to study Arjuna's question. Arjunaha uvacha. Arjuna asked. What did he say? He Janardana buddhihi karmanaha jayasi. Buddhihi means atmajnanam, self-knowledge. In Sanskrit, almost every word has got different meanings in different contexts. Because Sanskrit is a live language where different suffixes and prefixes are used to one root, and each affix has got a different meaning according to context. So buddhi is derived from the root budh, to know, and a suffix has been added ti. So, buddh plus ti is buddhi. This suffix, according to context, can refer to different things. Either it can refer to an object of knowledge, that ti refers to the object. Buddh means what? To know. Therefore, buddhi can refer to an object of knowledge. Buddhi can refer to instrument of knowledge. Buddhi can refer to knowledge itself, whether it is objects, whether it is instrument, whether it is knowledge itself. We have to see the context and know. In the Tamil, buddhi namadha buddhi irukka kagramalya. And the adathala buddhi refers to what? The instrument of knowledge. But in this context, the word buddhi does not refer to instrument, but it refers to knowledge itself. Jnanam. And that too, what jnanam? Atma jnanam. So, this atma jnanam is karmanaha jayasi, appears to be superior to karma. From your second chapter teaching, it appears, O Krishna, that jnanam is superior to karma. Why? Because you have praised jnanam in the beginning, you have praised jnanam in the end also, and you have presented jnanam as the remedy for sorrow and conflict. Therefore, I assume that jnanam is superior to karma. And then Arjuna says, this is not my presentation. Neengale ipidhan solrikeer solli avara quote pandrar. Iti te mata. This is your teaching. And then what mischief you are doing? After glorifying jnanam, vilindu thiraprajnana patti nanna pesinathukapram, then you are asking me to do what? Maam ghore karmani niyojayasi. Instead of inspiring me to go to some ashrama and study the scriptures, you are asking me to go to where? To this battlefield, and you are engaging me in action. And we all know that action does not produce any knowledge. That's why we call it karmendriyani. Karmendriyani cannot produce any knowledge. If you have got any doubt, daily morning, you wash your room for 1 hour and see what is the new knowledge you have gained. Or you want to know when is the Tamil Nadu Express coming to Chennai Central, you want to gain the knowledge, you do half an hour running. Will you get this knowledge? Karma cannot produce jnanam. So, you are glorifying jnanam and you are engaging me in action which is of no use at all. And there too, if the action is a noble action, it is a pleasant action, it will be fine. Like some people come for vote of thanks and say, it is my pleasant duty. And mudikive mata ellara epatha ponanundirpa. But he gets a nice stance in front of the mic, therefore goes on and on and on and on, because it is a pleasant duty for him, even though it is an unpleasant duty for the audience. So we know that certain actions are unpleasant. For Arjuna, if it is a pleasant action, it would have been fine. But you are engaging me in what action? Ghore karmani, which is a terrible action, bloody action, because it involves blood flow. And that too killing whom? Not Karna Shuna, Arjuna will be ready. But in front of his mental eye, his dear Bhishma, dear Drona are standing. Therefore, how can I think of killing them? So, maam ghore karmani kim niyojayasi. Kim means kasmat. Why do you contradict yourself? Glorify one thing and engage me in another thing. Continuing. So Janardana and Keshava are names of Lord Krishna. Vyamishreneva vakyena. Buddhim mohayasiva me. Tadekam vada nischitya.